Well, here we are at what's left of the Priory, which once dominated this part of the town.
Yes, when you think about it, the Priory is a sort of standard part of the landscape of a lot of our medieval boroughs, but this one was a bit different, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, it was. I mean, for a start, it was founded by a Breton, a man named Wehenoc, who was the first to hold the new lordship of Monmouth.
So I suppose he would have been more in tune with the local Welsh than a Norman lord would have been.
It certainly looks that way, because both Welsh and European saints were venerated here.
So what's left of the Priory buildings?
Not much. So much has been rebuilt and remodeled. These are parts of the Priory's separate accommodation. They were used as a church school in the 19th century, which is why they've been repaired and preserved.
That's a wonderful late medieval window.
Yeah, this is the one called Geoffrey's window.
That was Geoffrey of Monmouth, wasn't it?
Yes, and he wrote down a lot of stories about King Arthur, but in fact he lived in the early 12th century, and this window is at least 300 years later than Geoffrey.
Oh, and look at those corbels, those huge carved heads. There's an angel in the middle, and one of the townsmen with his liripipe hat, and the one on the left is supposed to be a knight in chainmail, but it looks more like a beadsman to me.
So the Priory could offer good buildings towards the end, but they were in difficulties, weren't they?
Well, yes, the Priory in the early 1530s got into a real financial mess and had to be replaced. But we do have to be careful about this, though. When Thomas Cromwell was working towards reforming the church, he sent inspectors round all the monasteries. And they did what inspectors so often seem to do. They found all the things that were wrong. And in the case of Cromwell's inspectors, it's quite clear that if they couldn't find enough dirt, they made it up. But when the commissioners came to close down the Priory a couple of years later, not only were there several monks still living there, there were the two curates of St. Mary and St. Thomas who were also getting board and lodging in the Priory.
Yeah, but the Priory was closed down with all the others, wasn't it?
Yep. Let's go and look at the other surviving monastic building, which is the church.